In this video, we'll see how to control servo motors with the MSP430 using compare mode timers for creating PWM. We are going to control the rotation angle by setting parameters in the code as well as using a potentiometer. In the first setup, we are going to connect the VCC and the ground of the servo to the 5V and the ground pins on the launch pad. And we are going to connect the PWM pin of the servo to the P1.6 pin on the launch pad. Getting the 5V from an external power supply can be preferred. In the datasheet of the SG90 servo, it said that the period must be 20 milliseconds and the pulse width should be between 1 millisecond and 2 milliseconds. However, according to my trials with the MSP430, these time intervals rotate the servo about 90 degrees. So I'll be using 2350 microsecond interval to rotate the servo between 0 and 180 degrees. I also need to mention that the maximum value with a movement is 2600 microseconds, which means a rotation of nearly 200 degrees is possible. In this first example, we are going to move the servo 180 degrees. For this, we are going to use the compare mode of the timer to produce PWM. We'll be working at 1 MHz frequency and we are going to be setting the period as 20 milliseconds. And we are going to set our pulse between 350 and 2350 microseconds to set the rotation angle between 0 and 180 degrees. Now, let's debug and run the code. And let's click on resume. You can see that our servo has started rotating between 0 and 180 degrees. Now let's see what happens if we set the maximum value to 2600. Okay, let's click on resume. You can see that the angle is more than 180 degrees. It's nearly 200. In this example, we are going to see the rotation in a more smooth movement. We obtained this with the for loop. Now, let's debug and run the code. My cable is not connected. Let's connect it. Let's click on resume. And you can see that it goes to the minimum location and then rotates in a more smooth movement. In the second setup, we add a potentiometer to control the rotation of the servo. We connect the potentiometer's VCC and ground to the 3.3V and ground pins on the launch pad. And we connect the output of the potentiometer to the P1.3 on the launch pad. Now let's see the code for this setup. In the second setup, as we run our code, we'll be able to rotate the servo by using the potentiometer. Now let's debug the code. Let's click on resume. You can see that as we move the potentiometer, the servo rotates. This was the end of the video. I hope it's been useful for you. If you have any questions or comments about the code and the experiment, please write them in the comment section. Thank you for watching and see you in another video. Bye.